here at iHOBBY 2007 in the Spektrum booth with Mike Senarecki. Mike, you've got the hot new DX3R in your hands. What can you tell me about this new radio system? I hear it uses DSM-2 technology. What does that mean to the end racer?
Well, basically the DSM-2 technology is the new protocol that basically gives us the faster response rate that everyone's been looking for. It kind of gives you that consistent edge around the track, keep that line going, and basically just the frame rate and the latency has been improved, and now we have like basically a pro class level radio going.
Now, with this, was one of the first things I noticed when I held the radio was how light it was. Was that one of the major goals going forward, starting with this project, or what were the major goals that you guys were looking to accomplish with the DX3R?
Well, with the DSM2, it actually is more efficient, so it doesn't use as much voltage. So we reduced the amount of battery that it has in there, so it's got a lighter feel. And we're noticing that racers really like that on the long mains and those long races, that the radio's not getting heavy. It's real light. It's almost like an extension of your hands. You don't have to worry about the weight. So now, that helps out a lot.
Now, with the DSM2 technology, does that mean someone's going to have to replace all their existing receivers if they already have either a module
right.
system or a DX2 or a DX3?
Great question. Actually, the good news is that if you don't have a DSM2 receiver and you got a bunch of existing DSM standard receivers, this will work with it. What will happen is when you go into bind mode, it's going to look for DSM2, and if it doesn't find it, it'll default back down to the regular DSM. So all the receivers you already have, good to go.
Now, you can also adjust the frame rate on this radio as well. What will that do for racers?
Well, it just depends on what you're looking for. Monster trucks, obviously there's not as much accuracy there that's needed, but some of these carpet racers or on-road cars, having that latency and that fine line is real important, so you can actually increase or decrease that depending on what you're driving.
Now, how is the radio going to come bundled? Is it going to have multiple receivers? Is it coming with servos? How exactly will racers be able to get this?
At this point, we're just going to offer it with the receiver, and as far as servos are concerned, it's just up to the racer. There's so many options you can have with this radio that it's probably best just that you get the receiver and transmitter and go with what you need on servos.
Thank you, Mike. That's Mike Senarecki here in the Spektrum booth at iHOBBY 2007.